my channel. My name is Maya. If it's your very first time here, so today I am responding to some requests for me to do a green look with the ILUVSARAHII by ColourPop palette. Oh, this matched my eyes, y'all, and I just realized that. So I actually wanted to get my hands into the emerald green color that was in this palette, and then I started getting requests for it, so I was like, yes, I gotta do this now. Sometimes when I say I'm gonna do something, I forget. Let's just be honest. So I didn't want to forget this one, so we did it back to back. This one is not gonna be a review. My last video was a review of the palette, kind of, you know, giving my thoughts and all that good stuff. This one is just, you know, we chilling, we sitting back, we doing this simple eye look. Sit back, grab your drink, put your earphones on, you know, to everybody in the house to be quiet so we can just, you know, have a little girl time. But before you keep watching, please make sure you have hit subscribe below. I wanna see you come back. I wanna see you join the Galore gang. And if you join today here, you gotta join on Instagram too. So make sure you follow me on Instagram. Make sure that you have subscribed to my channel, and we're good. I'll see y'all at the end. Quite a few of you guys requested that I mess with this emerald green in this palette, and that's exactly what we are going to do today. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and prime my eye. This is with my Tarte Shape Tape, which is in deep, and we're gonna hop right into this eye. This eye is actually extremely easy. If y'all notice, she is a blended eye. Maya never does blended eyes, but that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna take this brush, and this is actually from Dose of Colors. I got this in, I believe, the Snow Angels palette, and I love it because it's very precise. It lets you really get a precise placement of the shadow, which actually makes it a lot easier. So I'm gonna dip into Moody, which is this green color, and I'm going to just watch what I'm gonna do because I really just want that deep color on the edge, and then I'm gonna blend it out. So essentially we're just placing the color. We're gonna pat it on, and then we're gonna flip it over to this side. Y'all, excuse my nails, they are so ratchet and it is so embarrassing. I'm sorry. I'm gonna flip it over, and then we're gonna use this side to blend it out. So I'm using like circular motions, like right at the edge of it, and then I'm flicking it outwards so that it fades away. I feel like this could also, you know, you could also blend this out with like a different color too if you want to have this to be like, you know, an ombre type of situation, but I kind of just want to stick with the green. I don't know if you guys can notice the difference. Typically when I'm at this point of the video, my eyes looking like somebody just slapped some mud on it, but right now it's looking still really structured, and I like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my makeup wipe. We could start with some tape if we wanted to, but I didn't, so I'm gonna go ahead and take a makeup wipe, and I'm going to just make this sharp. The next color we're gonna go into is Mesmerize, and that is this gold color here at the top, and I'm gonna dip into that, and I'm just gonna place it in this area and just pat it on and blend it out. Yeah, I'm so proud of myself that I'm doing a blended look. I never do blended looks. Not that I don't like them, but I don't know, I feel like I love a structured eye. I just navigate towards the cut creases more, but I just really like this. So right next to that color, I'm gonna go into Emerald Dream, which is the exciting color that we all been waiting for. And that's this color right here. And I'm actually gonna take my finger, I'm trying to take one that's a little less chipped, and I'm gonna dip it in there, and I'm gonna just put that on my lid. All right, so once I have that placed, I'm gonna go ahead with my other brush that still has a little bit of the gold on it, and I'm gonna blend those two together and just dust that color out. And that is basically it, guys. Like, super easy. Since so many people asked me for this color, I wanted to do something that was really easy to do, because I know, you know, cut creases are not always everybody's strong points. I feel like this is easy. It gives you the green, it gives you some pop of gold, and we're good. So I'm gonna go ahead and put on some liner on my top lid, not too much, just to define the area for the lashes, and then pop the lashes on. I think that might have been like the easiest, quickest look I've done, like, ever. Y'all know I like to do the utmost, so that was super easy. Let's get into this face, y'all. So for primer today, I am gonna be using my e.l.f. illuminating primer. I've said it before, I love the illuminating effect it gives you underneath your foundation. Y'all said a couple videos ago I wanted to get like a lifestyle backdrop, and I'm still working on that. That's gonna happen. I don't know, like I told you guys that I didn't want to use my colored backdrops anymore just because I can't figure out how to get my lighting together because of my older videos, which, by the way, I just celebrated my YouTube anniversary, which was at the end of December, because I posted my first YouTube video December 27th of 2017. So it's been a year. So speaking of my older videos, I did mention that I wanted to get a different backdrop because I can't fix the color. Like, if you look at any of my older videos, I'm like real orange. That ain't cute. So the white gives me, like, you know, regular skin complexion, regular skin tone, normalness. But I feel like I wanted to get something different. I'll use my backdrops once I figure out the lighting, but I really want to get like a lifestyle backdrop. So this foundation is the NARS Natural Radiant Foundation, and this is in Macau. I did want to say just thank you to everybody. You know, over this past year, I've been able to gain over 3,000 subscribers, which I'm so grateful for, and I'm excited to see where we're gonna grow to this year. But I've learned so much this year, I swear, like, I've learned so much, not just about, you know, being a YouTuber, being a beauty blogger, but mostly just life stuff. This, like, doing this and having my channel and everything has really just helped me to not be a procrastinator anymore. And that's so crazy because I wasn't expecting it to have that effect on me. So it's definitely helped me just to stay more on top of my stuff. Cause before this, I was a serial procrastinator. Let my boyfriend tell it. That's what he'll say. For concealer today, I'm using my Tarte Shape Tape, which is in Deep. And I feel like I haven't used this concealer in a while, so I'm happy that she is making a comeback. I know a lot of makeup artists or a lot of YouTubers don't like to actually put concealer here. I love to put concealer there. They just kind of take the rest of what's left on their, like, Beauty Blender or wherever they apply it with. But I like an extra little snatch right there, so I like to actually put concealer in that area. So I'm also gonna take a lighter concealer as well, and this is ColourPop, and this color is medium 26. I just like to add a little extra underneath the eyes just to brighten me up when I blend it out. And then, of course, my favorite thing to contour with is Fenty Beauty, and that is the Matchstick in Espresso. So when I blend this out, I like to use my Real Techniques blending brush. I feel like it's the best tool for this, and I blend it inwards and then I blend upwards. Of course, I'm gonna have to go over this with my beauty blender, but that's how I like to blend it. And then I'll blend this and then I'll, like, push it back into the hairline. So for powder today, we are gonna go ahead and use Laura Mercier. I'll go ahead and set with the translucent powder, and then I'm going to put my medium deep powder everywhere. And I really like to push this skin complexion powder into my smile lines because I have a lot of problems in that area, like a lot. And I want to make sure that that is taken care of. That kind of helps me throughout the day. You know, when I'm smiling and everything, it doesn't settle into those lines, you know, as much. So then for bronzer, we're going to go into the Prime Beauty bronzer. I have talked about them before on here, I think 2 videos ago. But shameless plug, brown girl bronzers. If you having problems, which I believe most of us do, finding a good bronzer for your skin complexion, they're perfect. This one is in Brownsville, and then they have one that's deeper than this, which is amazing. And that's kind of like unheard of for bronzers, which, you know, is still very sad, but, you know, I have to say something about them because it's amazing that they have 3 different shades of bronzers. They have one lighter than this, and then I have one darker. This is the medium shade. Like, just for my complexion to be the medium shade, I just feel like this dope. So we are back up close and personal with the eyes. My underneath the eye, I'm gonna go back into Moody, and I'm gonna put that on the outer corners. And I'm gonna go in with the other side just to blend that out. Towards the middle, we're gonna go back into Emerald Dream. And then next to that, we're gonna go into Mesmerize. Then I'm gonna go ahead and work Mesmerize into the tear duct area just to give us some shine. Now I'm gonna go ahead and put on some liner on the bottom lash line and some mascara, and we're done with the eyes. For highlighter today, we're gonna go into my favorite highlighter. Y'all already know what it is, and it is Pose Shayla by ColourPop. I tried to pay attention to my other highlighters, but it doesn't work, and that's fine, you know? The reason why this is my favorite, which I feel like I never say it, is because it's a gold, you know, gold works better for deeper skin complexions, but it's like a coppery gold, so it has like a bronzy type of thing to it. And that is what I'm in love with. I think, who was it? ILUVSARAHII, Karen, who has this palette, by the way. I think she's the one, she did an all matte face, like an all matte tutorial. And I've been thinking about doing that. I feel like that would be like real, oh, that was a lot. Blow that off. Look at me talking, doing the wrong thing. But yeah, I feel like that would be like a super dope idea just to do like an all matte look. I might have to try that next week. I don't think I've ever done a look that did not have highlighter on it. Like, ever. So for lips today, I was thinking about going brown, but now I kind of want to go burgundy. I think we're gonna go burgundy. And I'm gonna go ahead and use my Ultra Matte Lip by ILUVSARAHII and ColourPop, and this is in Sussy. And we're done. All right, love. So this is the look that we came up with. I have done a blended look. I am proud of myself. A lot of you guys have been like, girl, when are you not gonna do a cut crease? I love my cut creases. It's my comfort zone. It just really is. But, you know, sometimes you gotta step outside of your comfort zone, and I'm so glad that I did, because now I feel like this is something that I'm gonna do. Maybe not all the time, but sprinkled here and there, you know? We can do a blended look. If you guys like this tutorial and this chit chat situation, go ahead and give me a big thumbs up. Comment below if you want to. Hit subscribe below if you have not yet. I see you, girl, who have just sat here and watched this whole video and didn't subscribe. Come on, girl, it's free. Hit the button. And I'll see y'all next time. Bye.